I need y'all to like
comment, subscribe. You're me.
All right, so this is me talking real quick behind the scenes. Personally, I felt like this is just something I needed to record because we were just having a deep conversation. You know what I'm saying? These are the type of things I wish y'all could see, that I see. So you're in my eyes right now.
So basically, what I was saying was, like, I was reading one of the comments. Hold on. I had to refill the water with some fresh water.
We was just talking. Having our grown men talk that we normally do. So this we can almost say is like another behind the scenes of the realest conversation ever, because this is what we do. We just talk.
Amen. So I was reading one of the comments. Let's see. Dolphin Made Bully, shout out to you. And y'all don't get upset if I don't read everybody comment and say it right now, because you know what I mean? Hey, don't pass that gun line, bro. Dolph Made Bullies. Good shit, bro. Lord knows when the last time them people ate salute. You rarely see this, especially in the Baltimore trenches. Shout out to you. You know what I'm saying? I read that. And, Keithy, Boss Man really just taught me a couple things in that 5-minute talk. I seen that one. Shout out to Keefe. Michael Tahir Mahad. Okay, I just seen it. I'm just seeing this right now. Salute the Boss Man for feeding the homeless. Hit me up anytime, Ralph. Alright. Appreciate Boss Man. That's real nigga shit. And it's always fuck the haters, fam. Stay light, motivated and inspired. May Allah continue to bless you and your beautiful family as well. Shout out to Michael, man. You know what I'm saying? But I was reading the jumps as I'm taking a break doing the video of cleaning the kennel cage. So right now this is the video of cleaning the kennel cage. And I was basically saying, like, being a real nigga come with a price. You know what I'm saying? Like, I lost a lot of friends, you know, off being a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? Not that I fuck my friends over, you know what I'm saying? Just the shit I stand for and the shit a lot of other niggas stand for, I just don't fuck with. You know what I mean? Like, I have partners that are cool with niggas that ain't cool with me. For me, if it's fuck me, it's fuck him. You feel me? So I look at shit different. You know what I mean? Like, if this nigga done me something dirty, or he trying to do me something dirty, how can you go hang around that nigga knowing that nigga is trying to do me something dirty? You know what I'm saying? So it's like, I lost a lot of friends by being real. You know what I'm saying? Like, and one thing about me that's messed up is I'm 90% right all the time. And it's something that you don't believe until you actually like be around me and I say it to you and you encounter like a situation and you be like, damn, that man just told me. But see, like, being right, that's a gift and a curse, because you could be just trying to give game to one of your partners and they take it as, oh, you think you know everything, you think da, 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 da. You know what I'm saying? But it'd be like, nah, bro, it's not really that I think I know everything. I'm gonna tell you what it is. And then, what, a week later, 2 weeks later, boom. Same thing I just said was gonna happen. So it's like a gift and a curse. So being a real nigga is like, I like it. I like that, you know, I'm solid. I like that, you know what I mean? I like that I stand for something. But then at the same time, you know, it take a strong individual to actually deal with me. You feel me? Like, it take a strong individual to deal with me. Because it's not easy. It's not easy, you know, being around me. It's not easy dealing with me, you know? Shout out my nigga D, motherfucker Dorian Maxwell, shout out D. But I remember, like, D was like, he had said something to me. I ain't talked to the nigga in a while. And then when he finally caught up to me, I'm like Obama and shit, like, you know, try to catch up with me. They gotta be a special motherfucker to hit me, like, you dig? And this YouTube shit, this YouTube shit don't make it no better. Like, nah, nigga, Rio, you want me to get fancy? I'm gonna get fancy, bitch. You thought I was fancy when I was, look, my nigga Samir is 24 right here. I'm gonna answer this for this now. I'm gonna answer it for him. Hey, look.
What up, bro?
I say, look, I'm gonna answer this junk for you. I say, you on the vlog right now, cause I'm vlogging. But I said,
My bad.
Nah, it's all good, nigga. I just said I was gonna answer that junk, man. Go ahead, shot your shit out, my boy.
They goddamn cut on kennels, man.
Say it again,
Say it again, bro. Whatever, man. Cut them kennels on YouTube.
Cut them kennels on YouTube. What else you said?
I just had a question for you, man.
What's happening, pop?
Hey, look. I had you or whatever, but I guess you were doing your car. My female, man, she bleeds. Like, you know, it's my first time doing it, man. What's the process with that, with the freeze situation, if she bleeds, in her first day bleeding?
If it's her first day bleeding, then you gonna count like 7 days.
Okay.
Like, are you for sure that it's her first day?
Yeah, and I've been paying attention to her.
All right, well, when she stop bleeding, that's when she gonna be ready.
Already.
You know what I'm saying? So, already, son.
Already.
Yep. Yeah, but you know, it's a gift and a curse, man. And actually I hate it because, like, for me, you know, so I was a target before YouTube, and with YouTube it just made me become more of a target, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not a sucker at all, you know what I'm saying? And I put that on my kids, I put that on everything I stand for and believe in, right? I'm not a sucker at all. I've never ran from no man. I never backed down from no wreck. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a sucker at all. They're like, I've never snitched on nobody. I've never anything that violate the code of the streets, I've never done. You know what I'm saying? The worst thing about, the baddest thing about me that you can say about me is that I be having feet in the wilds. That's it. And, well, at least I get tail. How about that? Cause some niggas don't have female problems. So I'd rather have female problems than, you know, be a sucker, be labeled a snitch. You know what I'm saying? Niggas say I'm gay. You know what I'm saying? Cause, you know, it's, all y'all know in y'all area, it's a lot of niggas. I done heard about him, woo, woo, woo. You know what I mean? So for me, it's like, oh, that's what I was saying. I'm gonna just jump back to what I was saying. So shout out my nigga D. D was like, man, nigga can't go out with you nowhere. And I was like, huh? Like, man, you always getting into something. I'm just like, hold up. So, like, all right. So, for me, it's like this, right? This how it is with me. I'm the nigga that, like, I'm going to pop off. But I'm not going to, like, initiate it. Like, I'm going to be cool. But then I'm going to pop off. But I don't really initiate nothing. So, like, I have an incident, like, all right, put it like this, right? So I'm at my cousin Rick house, you feel me? And, like, Rick older than me, you know what I'm saying? And I always looked up to the nigga, you know what I'm saying? From a kid, like, I smoked my first J with that nigga, you know what I'm saying? Like, and that nigga used to, like, when we was young, he used to fucking bully me. I remember the nigga threw a jellyfish on me at Ocean City, and the jellyfish had stung me or something, I don't know, I was crying. Nigga put me in the fold, like, all that. Like, I used to go through that. But I remember I'm at his house. He older. He got his life all the way together. You know what I'm saying? A good dude really don't even like to be involved in fuckery. You know what I mean? But he had a partner over the junk. And, you know, I know this nigga Rick the same way his man know him. But it's like, I know him. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, Rick was doing his thing, he was doing this, he was doing that, but on the level of trapping that he was doing and the level of trapping that I was doing, I wouldn't consider him no street dude, you feel me? So I remember it was me, Rick, and the old head that Rick worked with. If you ever see this, shout out to you. And we having a conversation. Everything straight. Me and dude, everything was straight. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything was good. You know what I'm saying? But then he disappears. And while we talking, he disappeared. Then he just come back turned up, right? He was turned up. And we was talking, and I was like, but yeah, but Rick, you ain't no street nigga though, Rick. He was just like, and the nigga was like, he was like, what? And then, you know what I'm saying? He had a 380. He had a 380 with a 30 round clip on that jump. So he pulled the jump out on me. Cocked the jump. Man, Rick a street nigga. Whoop, 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 whoop. You know what I mean? I look at the nigga like, did this nigga really just up the joint on me? So I called my wife. I'm at my cousin's house. I always got that blicky is always with me, dog. The thuka is always on me. So I go to I yell out my wife's name. I'm like, Christina. She's like, what? I'm like, where the keys at? She's like, get my purse. I go grab the keys. I go get my joint out of the car. My shit don't need to be in the house at my cousin's house. Like, I'm in my cousin's house. What the hell? I don't need no strap in my cousin's house. So I go get my junk from out the car, come back inside, whip my junk out, take his junk out his pocket, put his junk in my pocket, and tell him you gotta see me to get the junk back. I fight the nigga. And that situation showed me that I fight the nigga. I'm damn near about to fight my cousin. That situation showed me that no matter what I do, I'ma always be wrong. My cousin was mad at me. His wife was mad at me. And it just kind of taught me something that it's like, this man could have killed me, you know? You feel me, see?
I do.
Like the man, he was on coke. He was coked up. He was coked up. So he could have, you know, you heard Pimp C. I know you strapped, but you cowards like to play hard. You know what I'm saying? I know you strapped. What that man say? Niggas like to get full of that weed and liquor. Snort a line in your mind that you a killer. Now he could have been one of them. And he could have cooked my noodles. Roman style.
I'm going 85 on a one-way road with a thing to my head, thinking gone, let it go. Nigga, you should go, thank deacons on the real. All a nigga ever said was, we gone, let it go. Some street trapping led a nigga to a situation that I never thought it'd be. Plus, I'm a nigga from another fucking city, so they looking at a mom.